Hi everyone, thanks for stopping by today. Today we're talking about the Teseq NSG 438 ESD Simulator or ESD Gun. So taking a look to my right here you'll find the NSG 438. In the video today we're going to be talking about the simulator. It's going to be an NSG 438A. So what the NSG 438A is it includes a bleed off functionality or a charge remover, just allowing you to expedite testing if you're looking for that capability. So just keep in mind if you do rent or purchase them, that is an added functionality you will see in the video. This video is going to provide you with a basic overview of the system. We're going to walk you through some of the accessories, how to set it up, a little bit about the interface, and then how to toggle through menus, and then finally how to select different testing parameters. Just keep in mind as we're walking through this video and as we're walking you through the simulator that we rent them as well as sell them for as short as a week and as long as you guys need them for. We also offer a whole wide variety of networks and accessories if you guys are looking for something a little more specific, a little more niche than is commonly used. So that's one of the nice things about this Teseq NSG 438 is you can easily go out there and purchase additional networks should your testing require something beyond the more common 150 picofarad 330 ohm network. Okay, so why don't we open up the box here on my right. We're going to open it up and we're going to take a look and we'll start walking you guys through a little bit about it. All we've done so far here is just open up the case. You'll see a couple different pieces here. First one is going to be your calibration certificate right there. If you guys ordered it for the purchase, if you guys are purchasing it, you'll find it in there. Otherwise, if you're renting it, we have all of our simulators calibrated. So you will find that in there as well. That brings up the point of purchasing it through us as opposed to going through a third party or possibly buying it used, is that you're sure you're getting a quality product and you're getting that manufacturer's warranty with it as well. So if something happens with a simulator malfunctions, you're sure that you can get it repaired and get it repaired as quickly as possible. All right, so working our way from the left to the right, you'll find your base station right here, and you'll notice on the back here, there's some hookups there. We'll walk you through that in just a minute. You'll find the networks that I mentioned before, the automotive networks right here at the bottom. And again, if you guys don't rent or purchase those won't come with it, but just so you are aware, those are there. Taking a look right here, you'll find your air discharge tip. So that just slides right in there. You'll find your pistol stand right here. So that just slides right there. And then finally, looking right up here, you'll find the pistol itself. So taking a look here, you'll see the screen. And all you need to do is take the networks out. Just lean it forward right there like that. Pop this open right there. Take the network out and then change it. You'll see right there, we do have the 150 picofarad 330 ohm network in there right now. Just kind of give you an idea that for you guys that there is a network in there. All right, and then if you want to look at the tip right there, there's that contact discharge tip. All right, so it kind of gives you a little bit of an idea of how you're going to receive it and a little bit about the pieces here. There is a power cord there as well as some additional connectors that we'll walk you guys through here in just a minute. But that's just a little bit about it as you're going to receive it. So now we're going to go ahead and we're going to show you guys a little bit about how to set it up, how to plug everything in, and how to get everything working. All right, so taking a look here, you'll see the pistol. We did put it in the pistol stand. We've plugged in the power supply into the back of the system right here, and we're just going to plug this piece in. Just slides right in here just like that. All right, you just tighten these up, making sure you have a good connection there. All right, and now we're going to go ahead and plug it in. Okay, so you will see the battery light up right there. So what that means is this is actually a battery in the system. So it allows you to move this piece and the simulator to where you'd like to test to, and then without having to worry about a connection. So kind of a nice feature, and that's just with the NSG 438. So that's not, that is something you want to keep in mind. It's definitely a big benefit when you're doing different types of testing to be able to move this easily around. So we're gonna go ahead and take a look at the front right here. You will see power. So power on right there, boom. You can see right there, power, battery, interlock, interlock reset, and emergency power off. So that's pretty straightforward there. As I mentioned before, you can see some of the interlock output connectors that come with it, and those just go
right in the back of the actual system right here. So just keep in mind that there is this light up functionality here, and you will see, even when I turn the power off, the battery is still lit up. So that's just letting you know, hey, it's running off battery. So that's pretty straightforward there. One quick thing we wanted to show you guys out there too is the tips. So if you want to switch from that contact discharge to air discharge tip, these just twist off like that. You can go ahead and switch it out, and it just twists right back on there. So very easy to kind of switch these out. And as I mentioned earlier too, as the distributor for these ESD simulators, we also have the capability to distribute and sell a wide variety of other test accessories for these simulators. So if you guys need specific tips or anything along those lines, feel free to shoot us a line as well. So we're just gonna stick this right back here for the time being, put it right back in the stand. And now we're gonna walk you guys through a little bit about the menu and the touchscreen of the NSG438A. Here you'll find the touchscreen of your NSG438. ESD simulator. So we'll start here on the left side. Plus button right here is your polarity, so you can adjust that from positive to negative, negative back to positive. Got your voltage right there. Click on that, and you go ahead and change that. We'll change it to 4 kV for our situation here. Click on the next button right here, and that's your repetition. Alright, pretty straightforward there. And then down here, you'll see the resistance capacitance network. As we mentioned earlier, we have that 150 picofarad, 330 ohm network used for IEC 61000-4-2. Again, there's a whole wide variety of networks out there to help you out for your testing needs. So feel free to drop us a line if you're looking for something like that. Go up here. This is just a little walkthrough telling you about the trigger. All right. This is going to be your air discharge versus contact discharge detection. We're just going to leave it on auto, and then now we're going to walk you through a little bit about the settings. All right, so take a look at the menu here. You'll see standards, programs, activity log, language, device info, threshold, and a whole bunch of other great stuff there as well. You see ISO self-test, which is also nice. Kind of look through the top here. We're going to focus on the standards, so let's go ahead and take a look here. You'll see IEC 61000-4-2 and ISO 10605. So for our example today, we'll take a look at that IEC 61000-4-2. All right, you can see here on the different levels required by the standard. You can go through here and toggle through the menu and see all of them, but they are there for you, making it really easy to select it. So we'll just select the top one here. All right, perfect. And you will see that pop up down in the bottom here. All right, so that's a little bit about toggling through the menus and the touch screen. Again, there's a whole wide variety of features out there. So you can go out online and check out the Teseq video they made, or check out your user manual and data sheets and stuff like that to get more information out there. All right, so that kind of wraps up the video we're gonna shoot here today. But feel free to give us a shout if you guys are ever in need of a rental simulator, like the one here in this video, the NSG438, or if you guys are looking to purchase any of the Teseq or EM Test ESD simulators. We have a lot of them in stock and can deliver them the same day we receive the PO. So thank you for your time, and we'll talk to you guys soon.